Hello and welcome to another Wargame Red Dragon video with me, Bubble Box, and today we are continuing with the Bubble and Silver and Vulcan today do deck series with the Eastern Bloc deck. We've done the individual Eastern Bloc nations of East Germany, Poland and Czechoslovakia, and now we're doing the Eastern Bloc deck. A nice deck to use, really strong coalition deck. I'll put the link in the description to that deck build that we did with Vulcan and Silver Raptor in the description below. But in this game on Hop and Glory, it's a conquest game, up to 750 points. And we're playing some decent enemy. Vulcan is going to be heading over towards Gulf, and it looks like the enemy is sending quite a strong force, although it's all one player it looks like, over towards Charlie and perhaps to take this town here. Silver Raptor's heading his main force over towards Foxtrot. I'm going to try and take the town here. And I'm setting my little command infantry in its MI4T over to Juliet. And I'm, as you can see, going to bring my units out over around the area of Juliet, just over the river. And looks like we've got some enemy moving into Delta and having a look to see what's going on over at Echo as well. But it looks like the enemy's managed to make it into the town here with some ATGM units and some anti-air infantry. I am showing this open this time. I've not got it closed, so you can't see the enemy. We'll see if that's a little bit more interesting. Let me know in the comments if you like this kind of commentary where you can see what the enemy are doing, or whether you'd rather have it just so that you can see what we can see. Because, of course, we can't see all these units. I'll just quickly show you. If you go to my point of view, you can't see much of what the enemy's got getting up to. But I'll leave it open and let me know in the comments. Now the first little skirmish is happening here on the left hand side as I bring in my units out on the right hand side. And you can see they've managed to put a lot of infantry into this town here with a bunch of Milans. And they're pushing forward with a Leopard 2 command tank. This is a very bold move towards Gulf by the enemy. Some flak panzers actually a little bit far in front. And some quite cheap KPZ tanks with not a lot of armor. Now, what's Vulcan got? Well, he's got some nice infantry, but the flak panzer are going to rip those infantry apart with their cannons. So, yeah. Now, Vulcan has got some nice tanks back here, some nice medium T-72Ms and a Moderna, which are going to do off with these Fuchs Milans, hopefully, although some artillery comes in and stuns a bunch of his tanks, won't do them too much damage. But they are pushing forward with their attack. The flak panzer, again, really good against infantry and will stun these armored cars, while the Leopard 2 actually joins in on the battle and one of these cheap tanks here as well. Now, Vulcan spotted this Leopard 2 and wants that attacked immediately. He wants that out of there. So, and he's also, and also a chop from the enemy is actually calling some help against Vulcan's tanks that he knows are sitting in this tree line. So a really interesting little battle developing here on the left. Silver Raptor has managed to take nice control of Foxtrot, and I've bumped into a bunch of tanks trying to sneak their way around my flank. I've got some T-55 Diners with long range 2,800 meter range Arcan guided missiles, which just manages to do the job as a Hornet comes in, tries to bomb the hell out of my units, but I've got a couple of flak there, and indeed it does take out one of my T-55 AMs. I've got some flak there though. I don't know if I managed to take that plane out. I've got some infantry going up there as recon just to try and see if there's got anything else coming. There's a Mirage coming in as well, dropping on my flak this time as they try to shoot it down, get another rocket off, one more perhaps, but it gets away. So a little bit of a skirmish, well, a big skirmish on the left, a little bit of a skirmish on the right to stop my push forward. I've got to get back and rearm and resupply these tanks, and I brought in another Moderna just to cover them in case they're bringing more tanks down through that area. But they've got some nice units also, nicely put around in Delta, some ATGM units at the front there. Now, meanwhile, on the left, it looks like Vulcan has counterattacked into the left-hand side with his T-72Ms and his Moderna, and has managed to take out that command tank out of Gulf. So a nice counterattack there by Vulcan. And it looks like Silver Raptor's been helping it out as well with some T-72s. Probably took out those Marders that were there. And is Vulcan going to continue pushing forward here? Of course, he doesn't know there's only a command in here. If he did, he would probably have continued to go forward. But if you put it on my perspective, you can see he hasn't got a clue what's in there. They could be full of stuff. So he doesn't know that. Although he has killed a T-72, a big command tank, which costs huge amounts of points, of course. So it's Moderna still having a pot shot at these Marder 1As here. Should take them out quite easily, I would have thought. Oh, actually misses that time. So quite a skirmish on the left here. Lots of attacking and counter-attacking. On the right, not a great deal happening. They've managed to get some Canadian rifles. NSWP has managed to get some Canadian rifles. He's just put them on the other side of this mountain just to stop me sneaking any units over the top there. I've managed to take nice control of the tree line here. I've got some flak in there. These are basically Tunguskas. And I've got a bit of recon once I unload it and a couple more of those T-55 AM-2s with their long-range missiles. Now on this side, it's brought in a Tiger. Two Tiger PHA-2s takes out another of Vulcan's tanks. It looks like, I think that's, is that the Moderna he's pulled back? He might have killed this Moderna, or he might be that he's pulled back there. I'm not sure. But that Tiger 2, there's a Sopel there coming into action there. One of the Sopels that Vulcan likes so much. And immediately they pull back their Tiger recon chopper as Vulcan follows it up with his Sopel, bringing in a couple more of these medium T-72Ms. So Vulcan should hold that position nicely. Silver Raptor's holding this position nicely as well, and looks like he's bringing in a newer. I'm firing off a little bit of RM-70 AP rocket power here into the position where I think their tanks are. Of course, I can't see, which is this tree line here. And indeed, they have got a Chimera in there and also a Challenger marksman. And they're bringing up a command into, probably put it in these trees here to get control of Echo, because this is, of course, a Conquest game. I haven't done their units too much damage with all that AP artillery. It's a little bit of a luck with the AP artillery, to be honest. They're putting forward a little Saxon here. This isn't anything to worry about. This is a scout, but my Moderna's going to take that out. This is just to see what we've got. As a Tornado, GR1 comes in. Looks like it's going for my T-55 AM-2. Did it drop? Didn't look like it dropped. Well, it did drop. It dropped behind here, look. Okay, so it just about missed. Okay, so we're kind of set this side. We've got some recon so we can see anything that's coming. As they start to artillery the position, they know that T-55 is in now. And I just bring my Modernas back and my T-55s just to get them ready for another push forward. Another Tornado GR1 coming in. To hassle me. Looks like they're mainly bombing in this position. He didn't get it the first time. It looks like he's coming back for a second go. Flak fire away. Take down the GR1. And this time, they're on target. And take my T-55 down to one health point. But we took down their Tornado, so that was a good good exchange for us. Now, in the meantime, in the left-hand side here, the enemy's bringing in a bunch of weasels. Some more infantry. Not sure why they're bringing the weasels in, because the range is very inferior in open ground. These are quite good in closed up conditions against infantry and also against helicopters as well, but on open ground like this I can't see them going up against T-72Ms really, to be honest, as Vulcan's reinforcing with lots of T-72Ms. He can get a lot of them in because they don't cost too much money. 55 points, really nice value for money tank. And he's got his Modernas up there to provide the big armour in front and a couple of Sopels and a newer as well. So a nice combination of units there ready for his, I guess it's three-point pushes. I can't remember quite what he says, but three where he uses tanks, anti-air and recon to push forward, although he hasn't got a lot of recon there at the moment. Now they are trying to get units into these buildings because they know that these buildings are kind of protecting them from being attacked in Charlie, so they're trying to get units in there. I'm just basically building up. I'm being artillery quite heavily in this area around here. They did have a little skirmish, we didn't show it, but they're well dug in. You can see they've got nice units positioned around here with their command, which they can shoot straight across this open ground if I attack across. And they've got a Chimera sitting in here, another big defensive unit, which can shoot across here if I push forward here with my tanks, which I continually try to do. And I'm putting some infantry up into the mountain here. You can see I do put a T-55 and immediately get hammered by these Milan 2s with the 80 GMs and have to bring that guy back. Meanwhile, on the left, the build-up continues from Vulcan. He's bringing some recon in now. One of these little recon trucks. Very nice. And they continue bringing some units out. Bring in a Kyler. Again, Kyler's good in kind of semi-built-up areas. Not so good completely out in the open against big tanks and medium tanks. Bringing her in recon. There comes the Kyler. So not wouldn't have been my choice of units to bring out on that side. I would have rather gone just for a couple of heavies and some anti-air, really. They've got some Jaguar 2 sitting there. Nice defensive unit. And some artillery. So it looks like it's going to go off here quite soon. Now, on my side, bring my Nibirskis over the top. They're kind of just sitting on top. Now, I'm not sure if the enemy can see my Nibirskis. Let's have a look. No, they can't see my Nibirskis. And can I see them? I can't see them either. So they're right next to each other, but they can't see each other. That's really weird. Okay. But their TH, this little truck, spots my Nibirskis and stuns them. So I have to just pull them back behind the mountaintop. So it's all gone a little bit quiet. Now they do start to go forward with these units. Now what I think they're trying to do is outflank Vulcan. I think that's what they're trying to do. I'm not sure, but that's the only thing I can think of, really, with all these kind of short-range units over there. But whether Vulcan can spot these guys, let's have a quick look. Yeah, he spotted them. They're clearly visible. I think he's got some artillery firing as well. Yeah, it looks like Vulcan's got a couple of one on Dava out as well. Silver Raptor's assisting me a little bit on the right-hand side and holding them well. Who's well dug in on the middle. So Vulcan spotted all these units. Yeah, they are. They're just trying to flank him, I think, is what they're trying to do. But he's moving his T-72Ms and his Modernas over. His Prams are coming over as well. They've got a bit of ATGM, some ATGM units and little cannon. So they've been spotted probably by this recon here. And they're going to get hammered. Now he has to turn and engage. He can't go back. He can't continue with his flank attack. And these T-72s are simply going to destroy these lightly armoured trucks here. Just the Kyler gets taken out. Now, what this guy does now, I think he kind of panics a little bit. He pushes forward with Jaguar 2s. And well, he pushes forward with all his units, really. He's got his Yak Panzers here, whatever they are. Again, these are very lightly armoured. The T-72s, they're highly powered. They've got a nice weapon with an ITO, and they might do some damage to these T-72s. But Vulcan's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and Moderna, 6 T-72s, and Moderna against 2 Jaguars. It's no contest, really. They're going to get taken out. Then he's got these Yago Panzers. Again, an okay kind of weapon, but very lightly armoured, and will get taken out quite easily by all these T-72s and the Moderna. On my side, it looks like I brought my Nibirskis back for a bit of a repair. I bought some ZSU 57-2s with their little, can shoot against helicopters, ground units quite well as well, just to stop them bringing any infantry over the top there. Bought in a couple more T-55s, and I am continually getting artillery in this area. Here they know I've got units in there. They continue artillery there. There's a tornado from NSWP trying to help his friend out. Does drop some bombs on top of Vulcan's tank push here. Vulcan decides to pull back and not to push on. Of course, he can't see exactly what they've got in this area. They could have had a load more ATGMs in the buildings and more Jaguars sitting there. So he didn't want to lose all of his tanks. So he brings them back. They're a little bit damaged, so he's going to buff them up and probably push again a little bit later. Now, in the meantime, on my side, I've got some T-55s kind of defending there. Again, the artillery continually coming in. I did lose one of my Tunguska-like flak pieces, so I'm having to bring another one in. I bought in my RM-70s. I don't know whether we saw that fire off earlier. It's got AP rounds, so I'm just using that to guesstimate where their armour is and try to damage their armour while I build up my Modernas and my tanks for try and do a push somewhere. But they've got some nice artillery they keep pounding me with. They've got these M109A2s, the British artillery piece. They've got some MPZHM, they've got one. Well, that's not brilliant, but it's got an HE power of 10 though, so. And they've got an AS90, very nice artillery piece there from the British as well. Bringing forward more medium tanks. Up against me, sitting here, he's got a Chimera, nice defensive position there. He's got a Challenger Mark 1. He's got a couple of Centurions sitting in there in defensive position. So he's got, oh, actually, those, luckily, those, looks like those ATGM units got taken out. But he's got more ATGM units here. And a fair amount of infantry in there as well. So it's slowed down a little bit. Everyone's kind of building up and just getting their act together, buffing up their units a little bit with logistics. There's a Hornet coming in. He spotted my Modernas. So he's going to have a go with its big bomb. And it's going to land right on top of my units. Oh, in fact, it just misses, which was really lucky for me. Oh, it does take out one of my flak there, my Tunguskas. Unfortunately, I've got a couple more coming up though. Bring my Modernas back. They're, again, they're damaged. As soon as I push forward, he does spot them. He's got a recon unit here and immediately brings out his planes. And I just can't get my units to go forward. And again, the Tornado GR1 coming back in again. Hopefully I can take it out this time. I did spot their tank here, so I'm bringing forward an Mi-24D to have a go at it. But he has got an ADAT sitting there. And that Tornado GR1 is going to get out again by the looks of it. Indeed it does. I'm getting a little bit of artillery help here from my allies by the looks as well. Spotted that Challenger 1. I've got some Kampfschwimmers going in over the top. Going to probably bump into these units here. Although they are very, very stealthy. Oh, in fact, it's Silver Raptor. They're very, very stealthy, so may not get spotted. Yeah, Silver Raptor's starting to help me over on this side. He's brought in some little trucks as well. And he'll bring in some more units later on, I believe. Now, in the meantime, they continue the battle. Looks like they've brought in some ATGM choppers. Or, in fact, it's just a simple recon chopper. I think, wow, okay. Not sure what that was all about. But it looks like Vulcan is bringing in... What's he doing? He's buffing all his stuff up. Bringing in some prams, which he likes so much. Tornadoes and Voodoos again attacking the same area over and over again. Now then, on my side, I've tried, basically, it's just a bit of a to and fro. He's brought forward some infantry and trucks. And I've had to respond by bringing in an Mi-24D, which gets taken out by this Aslav with its Browning machine gun, in fact. And they're actually pushing forward with these trucks and infantry. My LSTRs are probably going to get taken out here. They're not going to stand up to an Aslav with 20 diggers backing them up. So I did bring forward another Mi-24P this side, which has run out of ammo. Or in fact, it hasn't run out of ammo. It should be able to go back and get some shots off if it can get in range. Another Mi-24P coming across here. If he can get his cocons off, take out that couple of trucks, takes out one Aslav and take the other one out, hopefully. Yeah, so this is another, oh, an MI-24P is coming around this side. I'd like them to try and get, well, I suppose they can't get close and use their tertiary weapon, should we say, because they're just going to get taken out. Tornado GR1's coming in, attacking my T-55s again, probably. So the smoke there is probably to stop my T-55s firing as they push forward with tanks now. Got some Leopards and some Centurions and a Challenger Marksman there as well. Now I have to respond here by bringing across my Modernas as they continue their push with their Challenger, their Centurion and their Leopards and their other Centurion. They've brought them all out of these trees here. There's two more Leopards coming in from the back there. So I have to respond by bringing in my Modernas, which should make mincemeat out of these guys. Now Silver Raptor's giving me a hand. He's bringing in a Moderna as well as I fire my RM70s to try and take the sting out of their push. Now I don't want to lose these Modernas, so I'm kind of microing them backwards and forwards a little bit. There's a lot more artillery coming in from my allies as well, helping me out. Looks like Vulcan's firing his Ondavas over there as well. So Modernas go forward again, another MI-24P. And they decide that they're taking too much fire now, and they takes what's left of his units back and puts them back into a defensive position in the tree line there. So a nice little attack by the enemy there, but didn't quite come off. And they have saved some of their units as well. And they bring in a Lynx 3, one of these really nice Lynx 3. That's probably to deter my Modernas from pushing forward any further. They're nice Hellfire missiles. Now it looks like Vulcan's really well built up here now. He's got Modernas, T-72Ms. He's being artilleryed, but he's got some trucks out in the open here. He's got a fair bit of AA. He's got his prams on the flank there. Bit of recon, some more Osas, more tanks coming in. He's really getting ready for a push there. Whereas my side, I'm kind of pushing forward and having to go back, and it's all a bit of a to and fro here, which makes it an interesting little battle on the right hand side here, although without any real big breakthrough. Silver Raptor's helped me out a bit. He's brought in another Moderna, so he's got a couple of Modernas sitting over there as well now, as well as a couple of trucks. Looks like Vulcan's pounding this town now with his artillery. Hopefully getting ready for his big push. He's getting his T-72Ms in position. Oh, Challenger Marksman going to take out my MI-24P probably. Just manages to get out of there. It's spinning out of control completely. Oh, takes a couple more hits. It's just going to get her out around. No, it's back in control now. Good. So another quiet period in the game. They've brought out some more units on the left here. This time they've brought out a nice Leopard 2A5 supported with a Jaguar 2. Some more of these cheap tanks which just aren't going to cut it out in the open with their shortish kind of range and their poor armour, and a nice little recon there. Jaguar 2, Kyla. These are decent defensive units here. And he's trying to bring some ATGMs out, which is a good idea, considering all this lot is sitting here. So this is Conquest, of course, and so they do have to try and do something to gain some ground off of us. They are bringing in a command vehicle, probably to put in this area here. I'm firing off my RM70s again. These are the ones with the AP rounds. There's two versions of these, one's with AP rounds and one with HE, where I think their armor is sitting, again in these tree lines here and in these tree lines here. just to try to soften them up before I'm able to try and push forward. Looks like that Moderna just took out those two trucks fulls of HEGMs trying to get into position. There's one there. It's a bit in the dust, and that might be the other one, which is good because it means they can't put their ATGMs to fire across the open ground there, as they bring out a couple of flak panzers to join their little group here. And if they're hoping to do a push against this lot, good luck to them. So it looks like Silver Raptor's building up his tanks forces here. He's got three massive tanks in the front lines here now. Bringing in some more T-72Ss as well. These are all pretty pretty huge tanks. There's a little attack there, GR1s. As soon as they spot my tanks or anything moving up, in fact, that attacked this area here. I think they were hunting for my command, or Silver's command that he's put in the corner there. But luckily he's put it just away from the corner, so he didn't manage to take it out. Although they have put their command, have they put their command in? Oh, actually, Silver Raptor just pulls his out. I think I took out their command with my RM70s. So I'm bringing in more artillery. I'm bringing in a lot of artillery in an attempt to do a proper assault. So I'm going to fire all the artillery off first, and then we'll move in. So I've got nearly got everything I need. I've got my Moderna tanks. I need some T-55s to back them up. I've got some anti-air choppers, I've got some ZSUs up there, I've got some flak. I've got pretty much everything I need. It looks like they're going for it again on this side. Same move as before. I wouldn't advise doing it twice. He's got the same recon sitting here, he's got the same tanks, and they're pretty much not got anything really powerful enough apart from this 2A5 here. Couple of 1A5s, even those are just not going to cut it. So in they come yet again against all of Vulcan's forces sitting in the trees. So this is the big one. The 2A5 is going to do its best as it sees. Ooh, that was close. So they're trying to kind of outflank him, taking out one of the prams, but he's just rearranging his tanks here, and he's going to hit them right in the side. It's an okay move, but it's just not powerful enough with all these tanks sitting in here, all moving across, and they're all getting in range now, and they're going to absolutely hammer these guys. Whoa. Oh, that hurt. I think he's the only one. There's a Kyler there. There's two Kylers back there. Oh, he's down. And they're even pushing in with the final units they've got. I mean, he's all in here. I mean, he's moving forward his defensive kind of trucks here. This Moderna's going to make mincemeat out of those. Meanwhile, we have had a little skirmish over this side. I'm trying to push forward with my tanks here, T-55s. I think they took out my Modernas there, if I remember back to the game. Yeah, they took out. I did attack with Modernas. All these Challengers sitting here. So my T-55s are firing their ATGMs. These Challengers are just soaking up these ATGM missiles. Another one full in the face. And it just sits there and fires back all day long. finally take one out, but we're running out of missiles here. Again, these T-55s run out of ATGM missiles. They're going to have to get quite close to take these challenges. These challenges will make mincemeat out of them. So really, I need to just pull them back now, which I do. And bring in an Mi-25S. Just to have a go at these challenges, try to push them back. Again, another one full in the face. These are just... Look at that! How many missiles! Finally, they decide to retreat their Challenger 1s. Took so many missiles in the face there. Meanwhile, looks like Vulcan has decided to push forward. They've responded by bringing out a load more trucks. They need something more powerful than this. A load more sort of vehicles, anti-tank vehicles. So he's moving forward with all his infantry. He's got his Moderna up there. His T-72Ms have pushed forward. There's nothing left in this town now. They are responding, bringing out a Kyler. And for some reason a recon chopper. There's a Moderna there. Going to have that flak panzer out. That truck out. Anti-tank truck out. And now it's having a go at the Kyler. Poor Kyler. Not going to last much longer. There he goes. A couple of bombers coming in as well from Vulcan. He's thinking there's some infantry in there. He doesn't know there's not any infantry in there. You'd think you'd put infantry in there if trying to defend Charlie, but they didn't put any in. So it looks like he's nicely pushed into Charlie and taken complete control of the left-hand side with their command down. Meanwhile, we continue to skirmish on this side. My Silver Raptor has actually pushed forward, but he did get stuck off, got a bit of crossfire from these Milan 2s, and also the Challengers, which kind of reversed around the side here, away from my attack choppers. So he kind of got that in the face a little bit, did them a little bit of damage, and then had to pull back. My T-55s did join in, but again, once they've run out of their ATGMs, they're a little bit of a sitting target for these Challengers as I attempt to bring them back. These T-55s that I put in the deck, they are quite good for defensive duties. They're really not fantastic for attacking with, to be honest, especially against big tanks. They just haven't got the armor to deal with it. So after all that to and froing, I'm kind of a bit short of ammo and stuff. But what I decided to do is bring out a load of infantry and just spam the hell out of my infantry and attack into Delta. Because I've got all my rocket artillery ready. We've got AP artillery, we've got HE artillery out as well to soften up their infantry. So although it says RM70s, they're slightly different versions. We've got the HE version there, and we've got the AP version there. But time's running out for them. We're on 606 points out of 750. They start to bring in their planes now on bombing runs, but I've got plenty of flak there to deal with that. And all these units spamming out to attack into Delta very soon. Looks like Vulcan's venturing up with a couple of T-72Ms. They're bringing out lots and lots of armor again. They are big on armor on their team. Vulcan's attacking with a whole bunch of planes. Oh, he's attacking into this town, just trying to clear this town out again. No idea what's in there, but there's not going to be anything in there after this attack. And it looks like Silver Raptor's doing the same kind of thing as me, bringing in a load of infantry and Scott 2s to assault that town as Vulcan softens everything up, although there's nothing in there, of course. So I'm firing off now my RM70s, the AP rounds first of all, just to soften up any armour they've got hanging around over in this tree line and even in the town. Bring in a load of flak as well. And then the RM70 HE rounds go in, Second. The 272's there from Vulcan. Bit of a suicide squad, I think, just to see what's going on. It does stop them bringing in a lot of their tanks to the front line and diverts them off to that side a little bit. But they've still got more coming in, as you can see. It's all a bit desperation for them now as the points get close to the victory, as my HE rocket artillery start to fire into the town. There's a bit of luck again as whether you do the damage, but you will stun pretty much everything in the town. They've got a lot of challengers sitting back here though. He's just pulling them ones back. I think he knows what's coming, so he's getting ready for a counter-attack with his challengers. But here come the infantry. I do get a few stunned there, a few infantry pieces. Drop a few out and just put them on foot. The rest I'll leave just running in. The rest of the trucks I'll leave going in. A few of them I'll put on foot. But a lot of units moving in here. Again, he set up four more Milan squads there, getting side shots on my flak. That's coming in. Loads more infantry. The challengers make their way around the corner to attack my incoming infantry. And those challengers will make mincemeat out of my infantry with their 4 HE power. But at that point, the game actually ends. So, a nice little game there. Conquest using the Eastern Bloc decks. We did okay, I think, on the right-hand side. There's a bit of to and fro between me and NSWP on that side. Silver Raptor helping me out with his tank push and some infantry trucks and a command vehicle and stuff, holding the middle as well and pushing into that middle town towards the end. Vulcan doing a fantastic job on the left-hand side, doing his kind of counter-attack at the beginning of the game to hold on to Gregory, and then building up and doing his push and taking the left-hand side completely by the end of the game. So a really nice conquest game there, and I hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I did. Please do leave us a comment, and let me know also if you prefer me to leave the game kind of open so you can see all the units, or would you rather have it just seen from my perspective. Let me know that, and I'll try and do that more in the future. I kind of prefer to have it open, actually, having done that one, so that you can see, or we can see, basically everything that's going on the whole of the map. So leave a comment about that. Leave me a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video, and subscribe if you haven't done that yet and you want to see a few more of these types of game. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.